Hello friends, for years we've been battling the curly leaf virus on our chili plants. It is an annual ritual, so to speak. And after those battles have been won, usually it is a smooth sailing, but this year that has not been the case. After winning those battles with the curly leaf virus, we've had a devastating attack of white flies on all of the chili plants, each and every leaf, so much so that I finally gave up and just let the plants be, because it was just beyond our imagination, the strength, the level of the infestation. And I'm hoping that you all will give some suggestions, and of course there are some harvests too in spite of all of this, so I hope you enjoy the video. This is a chili plant that I started in February 2020, and now it's February 2021. It took many months and many battles, and you can see the extent of the whitefly infestation behind the leaves. This is visible so clearly only in the night. In the daytime, I cannot see that. This is so bad. I've never seen anything like this in all of my years before growing chilies, and obviously it's there on all the plants. There are three in line and all of them have it. It's just terrible. The infestation has been so severe that I've just given up on the spraying. I just got fed up of it. The leaves affected by the white fly, they just come off easily, they just fall off. It's a disaster this time. I've never had so much white fly infestation, and it literally sucks the life out of the plant. Each and every leaf of all my chili plants has been affected. This is the Thai prickly knoo. While harvesting, the branch kind of just broke off, so I got it in, and have a look at the leaves. It's been a disaster for all the chili plants this season. It's never been so bad, and the plants just don't come back from this. Even if I prune, it's just devastating this time. Let me know in the comment section if any of you have grappled with this situation this season or previously, and what is an effective method. I've tried the usual ones, but to no avail. I've used fruit enzyme, I've used neem oil spray, I've used the chili garlic and ginger spray, but to no avail. It's a very, very prolific variety, produces in abundance even when chilies are already there. Normally, like when you harvest the chilies and then there's a fresh burst of flowering and fruiting, but this one is very prolific. But see the devastation. Super hot chilies though, really fantastic. So these are the sweet paprika peppers. They kind of turn maroonish on maturing. On this particular plant, there is a mixed infection. You will see white fly, and there are aphids and ants, and I've also seen ladybug larvae, obviously. And here, this is the white bird's eye chili. It's fought many battles. Many of them are with the curly leaf virus, but after conquering those, it's had to go through again the white fly. This is the Italian golden Marconi pepper plant. Looking at it, you would feel as though I've not watered it and it's in desperate need of water, but that is not the case. It's been watered very nicely as per schedule, but the white fly infestation has damaged the plant so much. At the end of every day, the leaves wilt like this, and then they recover later on in the evening. and they're fine till morning, and again after the sun throws its rays on them, again they are looking like this, as though it's not been watered. So you can see how badly the whitefly kind of devastates the plant. It's incapable of doing its normal function.
Thank you.